what we're calling Umbra in Lucem, which clearly I'm not a Latin scholar, but that translates roughly to shadow to light. And the good news is for you, most of the shadow is over now. That was the dark stuff. The goal tonight is to, in addition to just inviting you into a space where you can relax, enjoy some powerful, beautiful music, also help you understand that the really joyous, great stuff that we hear musically and that we experience in life never quite makes total sense without the context of some of those shadows, some of those other moments. And so often, at least for me as a conductor, we spend a lot of time on the happy music, the fun music, the jazz hands, and the big bright songs, and the things that everybody recognizes. And every once in a while, dipping into those darker, quieter places just gives you a little context for some things. So you are in store for a really dynamic concert tonight. You will hear the mixed choir back again later with the full orchestra. You'll hear some from the women's choir tonight. A lot of contrast this evening, and hopefully a chance for you to hear something that you've never heard before. Before we move on, please let me introduce our executive director and founder, Mr. Joshua Baker.
Well, good evening, everybody. So if you've had a long, hard week, and you fought rush hour traffic to get here, and you couldn't find a parking spot, but now you're here. So everybody take a big breath, relax, turn to the person beside you and say, I'm so glad I'm sitting by you. I'm so glad I'm standing by you, Justin. And I might be a little bit biased, but aren't these musicians absolutely incredible on the stage? They can hear you. Give them a big round of applause. Organization. And what you will see tonight is one of our mini concerts and events and shows that we do all over Central Florida. And these musicians are Central Florida Community Arts Symphony Orchestra. And the singers that you see tonight will represent the almost 400 singers that sing in several choirs. Also, part of our programs is our Children and Youth Arts Program and our School of Performing Arts. We go out and do lots of shows and concerts, but at the very heartbeat and mission of who we are is to serve this great community through the arts. So we partner with other nonprofits and charities, and we bring the arts at no cost to help them with their mission and to help them with their goal. The musicians that you see tonight and the almost 600 artists in this organization have partnered with 77 charities in 4 years to give back at no cost. Can you give them a big round of applause for that? That's incredible. This organization also this year was named the number one performing arts group by the Orlando Magazine. And more importantly to us, the number one arts advocate by the Orlando Weekly. So some great accolades, and this organization is doing some amazing things. Thank you for being here tonight. Inside your program, you'll see the program listing to all of our fabulous musicians. You also will see a donation envelope inside there. If you believe tonight, and I know that you will, that this performance was well worth the $10 or more, would you consider giving to this orchestra and to this organization so we can continue to do what we're doing here in this great community. So I know that you don't want to hear me talk all night. You want to hear great music. So let's turn this back over to Justin Michoni. Can you give him a big round of applause? Our principal conductor, music director of this orchestra.
Thank you very much. I'll give the women just a moment to make their way around and be ready for the next portion of this concert. Like I said, you're going to hear some contrasts this evening. And this is a really unique experience for us. How many of you have been to any Central Florida Community Arts concert or performance before? Good. Most of you. Who hasn't? Let's see if we got rookies there. Nice! Right down the front here. Great to see the front. So if you've not been to any of our performances before, as Joshua was saying, our heartbeat is giving back to the community. And we're very fortunate to be able to do that with some ridiculously talented people. Every experience you have with us here is hopefully one that you enjoy, but more importantly, they are all going to be very different. If you've been to our recent orchestra concerts, just this past summer, we did very happy British music, and then a whole half of a concert of classic rock, Beatles, Led Zeppelin, et cetera. Some of which you'll be here again in a couple weekends, and we'll talk more about that later. So we're all about stretching ourselves musically, and hopefully you as an audience as well, giving you an experience that you've not had before. So in order to continue that experience moving forward tonight, I'm going to introduce to you our official, for the first time ever in concert, the Women's Chorale, under the direction of Mr.
Justin did with the whole talking thing. incredibly glad that you are here. And as we experience the depths of the shadow, where do we look for help?
Thank you.
He doesn't know this yet, but I just decided tonight I'm going to take him with me everywhere I go. When I walk into a restaurant, Kevin's going to go in first and go, "Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Justin." Just, I like the way you say it. And I just realized that sounds really arrogant. I like the way you say it. This is what you get when we need to cover time for the 100-piece orchestra to come back on stage, as you get me. Believe it or not, it is already almost time for us to take a brief break for intermission. One of the goals we set out for our musicians this fall, because it's only the middle of October and we just really started this music at the very end of August, was to not over-program. I have a tendency, I have a really long playlist on my iPod, so I have a tendency to want to play every piece of music I've ever loved, all in the same concert. And that can be overwhelming for musicians as well as for our audience. So the goal tonight was to give you just enough to move you, to make you think, to challenge you a little bit, to give you a great start to your weekend, and hopefully to entice you to come back and hear us again sometime. So the last piece that we're going to play before we take a quick break for intermission is the fourth movement from Dvorak's Ninth Symphony, commonly known as the New World Symphony. A little bit about Dvorak. He was a Czech. Some refer to him as a bohemian, the part of the world that he was from at the time, and I can't keep track of when the wars happened, when all the borders changed. Jeff tried to tell me earlier that if he was a bohemian, that means Queen wrote a rhapsody about him, but I don't think it's the same person. A hunch, it's not the same. And in 1892, he came to America to be the director of the National Conservatory for American Music in New York. And he was exposed when he came here to these rich, gorgeous melodies that he was not getting in Eastern Europe, most of them influenced by Negro spirituals, by the American Indian culture and the music, and he was often quoted as saying that was the future of American music was going to be found in those melodies and those harmonies and the pentatonic scale that a lot of that was built on. He was so moved by it that some of the best and most well-known compositions of his life came from the 3 years that he was here in America, including this Ninth Symphony, which he titled From the New World. When Neil Armstrong went to the moon in the 11th Apollo mission, he took one recording with him from Earth to the moon, and it was Dvorak's Ninth Symphony, which is kind of cool, I guess. Or else I read it on Wikipedia, you decide. The fourth movement, which we're gonna play, the finale from the symphony, is incredibly dark at the beginning and very glorious at the end, and it summarizes really is about. If you're a movie music fan, if you're familiar with John Williams, you will hear some familiar things. John Williams had a lot of influences in classical music, and Dvorak is one of them. The third movement, which we will not play for you tonight, has a little passage in it that goes dum dum da da dum 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 da da dum. And if you're familiar with episode one from Star Wars, Darth Maul, the dude with the red and the black face and the double-edged lightsaber, no, nobody? Okay, good, thank you. I was trying to figure if I just needed to get out more often. He kind of borrowed that theme from there, and you will hear at the very beginning of this fourth movement a few notes that he just may have borrowed when he was trying to craft the perfect entrance music for a particular shark. You'll get it in a moment. So before we send you to intermission, please enjoy the final movement from Dvorak's New World Symphony.